There's a lot of reasons driving to the basket is easy for some but hard for others, but most people don't ever think about some of the biggest underlying causes that it's difficult. In this video, I'm gonna go over the main reasons that it's hard for some people. Some of them are psychological, some have absolutely nothing to do with your ability to dribble a basketball, and others have everything to do with dribbling the basketball, but not for the reasons that you would think. By the end of this video, you'll have pretty much every reason top to bottom uncovered. And at the end of the video, I'm gonna give you the perfect way to eliminate whatever your biggest issues are. So the first reason comes down to a skill that causes a psychological issue, and it's your ability to finish around the rim. If you're not confident that you can get to the rim and finish over, around, and past defenders, then that's gonna do a lot of things to your ability to drive to the basket. Because if subconsciously in the back of your mind, you know you're not good at finishing at the rim, that's either A, gonna prevent you from driving to the basket at all, or B, make you hesitant to drive, and by the time you decide to take advantage of that opportunity, it's too late, or C, you're hesitant the entire drive to the basket, making it more likely that you're gonna get the ball stolen or lose an opportunity to get a layup on the way to the hoop. Now, I'm not saying you have to do a bunch of reverse finishes and behind the back handoffs and euro steps like you see me doing in this video. I'll have a simpler solution for you at the end of the video. But you do need more than one way to finish around the rim if you want to eliminate that psychological issue. The next problem is what I call going into rampage mode. Version number one. Version number two is coming later. Now, if you've ever seen the movie Rampage, it was a pretty bad movie, but basically it was about these monsters. And they were obsessed with getting to this certain location and were destroying anything in their path. But the problem was everyone knew exactly where they were going. Same thing's happening to a lot of basketball players. They decide they're gonna try to drive to the basket. They'll pull off move after move after move, trying to fake out their defender and get past their defender. And what ends up happening is that their defender knows they're trying to drive and the entire defense. And when that happens, your defender sags off of you, all your fakes have no effect, and the entire defense will wait for you in the lane. A better solution would be to be patient for the right moment, don't make it overly obvious that you're trying to set anything up, and then quickly react to the right moment with no hesitation or additional setup. That's big. So yes, you should be aggressive when you see the opportunity to get past your defender or quickly sell a fake to get past them, but don't go too crazy with one goal in mind of driving to the basket. Next reason it might be hard to drive has to do with the psychology of your defender and their positioning. And it all comes down to this: are you a shooting threat? Because if you're a shooting threat, that does a couple things. Number one, any shot fake or hesitation that you do, your defender is going to be much more likely to jump on it if you've hit some shots earlier in the game. Number two, if they know you've hit some shots earlier in the game or think you're a threat to shoot, they're going to play closer to you. And when your defender plays closer to you, now it's easier to get past them because now there's not all that space between you and them. Big tip I got for you on this is be able to hit shots from triple threat and from the dribble. That'll make all your shot fakes and hesitations much more effective in those situations. Next reason it might be hard for you to drive comes down to something that is both psychological and affects your actual ability to beat defenders. And it's having counter moves. Think about this. If you're good at the inside out dribble, but you don't have a good counter move for that, it's gonna be a lot harder to go into that inside out dribble with full confidence, speed, and aggressiveness. So by not having counter moves for your inside out dribble, you're now making the inside out dribble by itself less effective. But by adding a whole bunch of counter moves to it, you'll be a lot more confident in it, and if the inside out dribble doesn't work, you'll have a lot more ways to beat your defender. Big tip I want to give you for this though is don't just stop there. Instead of just adding counter moves to the inside out, add counter moves to those counter moves. That'll keep you prepared for multiple game situations, give you different ways to fake out your defender, and allow you to be a lot more confident in the original inside out dribble. Not to mention by working on all those counter moves, that inside out dribble is gonna get a lot of repetitions in a lot of different ways and become really, really sharp for you. Next big issue a lot of players have with driving to the basket has nothing really to do with their handles. It has more to do with their legs. And what I'm talking about is your athleticism and first step off the dribble. Now, yes, you have to have a handle on the basketball while you're moving, but at the end of the day, a really fast, explosive player is gonna find it easier to beat defenders. You don't have to be quite so crafty, and if you are crafty, you'll get an extra advantage. One good way to make sure you're doing that is to try to minimize dribbles to get to the basket. I often will go from the three-point line and try to get in for a good clean layup in one dribble. Being able to do that can be the difference between getting your shot off because you get there before the help defense gets there, or getting your shot blocked. And it can be the difference between your defender sliding back in front of you or not. If you're taking more than one dribble, that means you can probably push that speed a little more. But keep in mind, just because you're taking only one dribble doesn't necessarily mean that you're being athletic and explosive to the hoop. You could still be pumping the brakes, so to speak, or not getting to the basket as quick as possible in one dribble. So focus both on that dribble count and the intensity and speed you bring when driving to the basket during your practices, so it can become more of a habit in game situation. Think about guys like Russell Westbrook. He's not the flashiest ball handler, but he's able to get past his man just about any time he wants to. Next reason is ball control, but not for the reasons that you're probably thinking about. Yes, just flat out losing the basketball and having it roll out of bounds or going to the defender, yeah, that's a problem. What I'm talking about seems much smaller, but it's actually a much bigger issue than you probably think. And there's two levels to this. The first is just kind of losing the basketball a little bit, but not to the point where the defender gets it or the ball goes flying out of bounds, but just enough that you have to take one extra dribble just to get control back over the basketball. When you have to do that, that gives your defender time to slide back in front of you. Maybe you fake them out, boom, they slide back in front of you. Maybe you see an opportunity to drive, and by the time you get control over the basketball, they've jumped in front of you. But the other thing is something I've seen some coaches recommend, and I'm telling you right now, don't do it. And that's to let the ball slide in your hand. There's a few instances where it makes sense to do that, where you really need to cover some ground and keep the ball in your hand. But for the most part, you can achieve that by gripping the basketball tightly. And that's the kind of grip I recommend you have on the basketball most often. And the reason is very simple. You don't have to take that little bit of time to get complete control over the basketball to push it where you want it to go, because you're already gripping it tightly. That's the difference between being able to attack when an opportunity is there and not. Also, if you're gripping the ball tightly, maybe you planned on going into a crossover and then you see the opportunity is open to drive. When you're gripping the ball tight, it's a lot quicker to move it in that direction instead. And when you're not gripping it tightly, the ball might not go exactly where you want it to go. And if it's off by just a few inches, that could open the opportunity for defenders to steal the basketball and slow you down, because now you have to regain control of the basketball on the way to the hoop. It's the difference between a defender sliding in front of you and not. And getting in a habit of frequently letting that basketball slide in your hands opens the opportunity to flat out lose the basketball bad a lot more often. Next reason you might find it hard to drive to the basket is because maybe you have rampage mode version 2. Version 2 is when you just decide you're gonna go to the basket no matter what, and you don't even spend time setting up your defender or trying to beat him. You just go, and you're a little bit out of control. Maybe you're losing the basketball. Maybe you don't have your footwork quite right on the layup. Maybe you don't have your feet set to get past your defender and explode into that first step. Or maybe there's 10 guys sitting in the lane and you just decide you're gonna go no matter what as fast as you can. All those are issues for obvious reasons, but it all comes down to your mentality first. So a better approach is to be patient and look for what the help defense is doing, and then react quickly, just like I told you to earlier on your setups. But with that, you also need to think about having counter moves that you can count on when you're picking up the basketball, as well as with your dribble moves before that in case a help defender jumps in front of you. But those are things that take practice and time to get down. If you don't have those moves down, then you're gonna have a hard time driving to the basket, because you're gonna be losing the basketball on the way. Maybe your footwork is off, you don't have good control, and now it's hard to even think about aiming for the layup. When you can't do that, you're gonna miss more layups. And when you know you're gonna miss more layups, that affects you psychologically that entire drive to the basket. That's why you gotta make sure you're getting down dribble counter moves like I mentioned earlier, having patience and attacking at the right moment, and that you have a variety of ways of finishing around the rim. Again, I will have a way to help you with that at the end of this video, as well as to help you with your dribbling. Next reason it might be hard to drive is maybe your fakes need some work. There's 5 big keys you'll wanna look at on your fakes to make sure you're being convincing on them so you can shift your defender out of the way. You wanna pay attention to your eyes, your hips, your chest, your foot, and the basketball. Get all those pieces moving in one direction, the more convincing it looks that you're going to move in that direction. And what I'd say the biggest key is to make any of your fakes work is that you've done the thing that you're faking. So if you want your defender to bite on your driving fake, then hopefully you've driven a few times in the game. If you want your defender to bite on your shot fake, then you gotta hit some shots. Now here's some ways you can master all these things. First of all the things you saw me doing in this video with the cones and dribbling, those are all things you can work on. Here's a video that'll help you with your finishing. This video will help you with your ball handling. This video will help you with your shooting. This video will help you with your first step. Be sure to watch all those and put them into practice. Subscribe and turn on all notifications to catch the newest videos.